Hello and welcome to Construction Wolf. Today I'm on the road again and I've ended up in Milton Keynes. So this is the first time I've actually been to Milton Keynes before. And you can see I'm in the MK Centre. There's a food court in the centre, just stopping for lunch. And I've actually heard there's a Lego store here in somewhere called Midsummer Place, which is another part to the side of the shopping centre. So let's go and check it out.
Just noticed these cool statues on the way out of the food court area. We've got this one of a dachshund. And there's actually a bird sat on top of the head, just looking for some food. We've got like a cyclist and a few other pedestrians too. A bird's in the takeaway queue. Right, we've made it to the Lego store in the Midsummer Place part of the shopping centre. See what's inside the shop windows. So we've got the Eiffel Tower here. See all the detail at the bottom. And it's a massive set. And the tallest set so far. No flag on it though. And this is the new Gringotts Bank that came out this month from the Harry Potter series. You see it's got this massive sort of track that goes to the bottom. And then we've got the new insects as well. And just below that, another new release, which is the Concorde. Quite a massive set as well. It's got its nose up at the moment, in flight mode. Got a very wide wingspan. And there's a little pointed tail end. And here we can get a closer look inside the store at the Gringotts Bank. So you see that sort of minecart track that goes to the vaults. It's quite a nice little piece, and you can see the car actually does roll down this track to the different vaults. And if we work up, there's a vault there. Then here's the actual bottom of it. You can see it, base plate just sits on top of this structure, and then there's the bank itself. So nice detail on the inside. You got to see the cracked pillars. I think they're printed pieces there. Looks like a chandelier in there. And we've got all sorts of stickers in this set with different Harry Potter references. I can see a brown frog here under the building there. Not sure what that's a reference to. We've got the upper floor. It's a bit hard to see with the reflection off the glass, but you can see like a chest in there. We've got a few owls on the outside. And some more graffiti. There's a dragon on top. Here's a closer look at the insects. We've got the blue butterfly. The mantis with the nice flowers. Then the Hercules beetle. I like, you can see under the wings with the sort of coloration there, where it's in flight. And down here you'll see there's also a bee with a blue butterfly on a flower. Really like the coloration of the blue wings. And here's Chewbacca that greets you in the store. Massive build, let's have a look. It's about 22,000 pieces, 39 kilos, very heavy. And he's dishing out the hand sanitizer for anyone that needs it in the store. Got a good range of sets on stock here. A lot of Marvel based sets. Then here's quite a new one, the Venomized Groot. Like his little sort of mouthpiece come off the side of him. And there's a Hulkbuster. And another range of Marvel sets. Let's see what's along here. All the Guardians of the Galaxy ships and masks. And actually this is something we've built recently, as you've hopefully seen on our channel, the Disney 100 camera. Really good build. Disney Castle. That's the box to the insects we just saw not long ago. Don't know if I'm really interested in this set, but they've got plenty of stock for people that want it. Butterfly is quite nice. And then we've got the Tranquil Garden here as well. This is a microscale set. It's really nice, but there's scale of it doesn't really fit with the sets I've got with minifigures. I do like the water lilies with the koi print pieces though on the water. Here's the Harry Potter section. Quite a large range of sets as you can see. Got the popular Diagon Alley here with a hanging cake. And then it's only September, but the Christmas stuff's already coming out. We've got the Harry Potter advent calendar there. A few trees in there. There's the Gringotts Bank we just saw earlier. Very large box. 4,800 pieces. And we've got a few nice sets here. We've got the owl. And yeah, some nice bottles actually, and even Lego brick glasses. notice here, these are some of the banner sections. You like a dragon, maybe, that one? And this is a Max Girl Hogwarts castle that came out recently. So I thought someone's dropping something back there. And we're on to Star Wars now. A few microscale ships dotted about, and actually I've noticed a lot of these like Dreams blobs hidden in the store, so maybe it's a little challenge for people to do and find them all. And yeah, large range of Star Wars ships, and oh, we've even got a Star Wars advent calendar. They've got this cute little creature at the top there, not sure what that is. See it? So look at the back, what's inside. We got a nice little range of mini builds. A few different Star Wars ships. And the massive AT-AT. I think these are out of stock at the moment though. You can see there's ample space inside to store like minifigures. £735 though. This is my favourite of the advent calendars this year, the Lego City one. You see the like ice sculpture in there, and I really like the ice hockey player. And if you just see in here, we've got a chihuahua, so I'll definitely be picking that one up. And here's the rest of the Christmas sets are out. Holiday Main Street. So I might try and build like a winter village and put some of these in. I've got the Christmas tree as well. Then this is a set I picked for last year, but not built yet, the Santa Reindeers. And these are new this year, I think some of these. Probably the bears I've seen before. But then these little tree ornaments, the gingerbread men are new this year. You can build and hang on your tree. Quite affordable. And these are the actual Lego passports you can pick up in store and get stamped at different stores. Like you can see in the dream section here, they've put a little maze in here, but there's no ball to roll around in it. Maybe it's a hint to the room gift we purchase next month. And just showing you here, these Dreams pieces, they have a lot of unique colorations, like this sort of pearlescent hairpiece. Definitely some pieces maybe worth picking up. And here's the Lego for adults section. Got a wide range of sets here too. Yeah, we've seen a lot of these releases recently in the Lego stores we've been to. Always do like the Lion Arts Castle. Have to get around to building that eventually. And he even has the cute little lamb in it. And this is relatively new out, and I do have a problem with this set I'd like to mention. So if you just see here on the Captain America shield, there's these big gaps in and you can see the light through them, so that does actually bother me quite a lot, which puts me off the set. I've got a load of brick heads on the side here. And these are relatively new out, the Sonic and Tails brick heads. I always like to check out the key rings when I come in store, see if there's anything new. Got Star Wars and Marvel, and then some of the more Lego themed ones as well. And they've actually got a Concorde that you can get up close and personal with to see in detail in the store, just on the counter. Got the little wheels that come through. And it even comes with this nice printed piece for the plaque for the Concorde. You see the underside. Well, quite detailed, looks good on the bottom as well, with the thrusters. You can see the landing gears fold up at the moment, but if you twist the tail in the back, they drop down. There's a clear look at the wingspan. As you can see, very wide. And there's the tail there. I like the detailing on the engines too, that looks really good. There we go. It's quite a nice set. And here's the PAB wall. So I might pick some pieces up in here for future projects. This is a decent range, a bit smaller than the last one we went to in Birmingham. Let's see what pieces we've got. Running out of these masonry bricks, only a few of the white ones. And a few of the grey ones left, they've been very popular. Then just appear plenty of leaf pieces though, so that's always good. And then they've even still got the gold pieces in. Could maybe build some autumn trees. And I think I'm going to buy a few pieces and we'll see how we get on back with the wolf. Oh, I'm eyeing up these rock panels, they look good. Maybe build a few mountains with these.
We're back from Milton Keynes now with the wolf. We're just about showing what we got. We didn't get too much, as I think there's going to be a double inside the points, or previously known as VIP points, starting October. That's happened the last few years in a row, so I'm going to wait to get any sort of major sets then. And also there's no gift with purchase available at the moment, as the Harry Potter ones have run out, and that was only on Harry Potter sets anyway. So hopefully some promotions come in the future. But what we did get here, we went to the PAB wall again. So there we go, you're interested in seeing these, are you? So we've got some leaf pieces here. We've got quite a few of those, and actually it's hard to see, there's some like rock panels in there as well. I tried to work out the most efficient way of packing them really, and I started to put them together with leaf pieces in, but then I dotted some around the side just to fill the dead space, because the rock panels are an unusual shape. Just filled them with leaves, because they're being used for building trees and doing greenery, you know, sort of later down the line. The final thing we also got, we just got a little bonus thing. Just rummaging here. We got this cute little llama keyring. Here's the little llama minifigure. I think that was one of the previous minifigure series. That's just quite a nice little bonus. So yeah, hopefully we'll be building some more things in the future, won't we? Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and if you could like and subscribe, that'd be much appreciated. Until next time, it's bye from us. Bye.